Well, y'all saw how that motor was just a kind of bumping. It's under warranty. These are Broad Ocean motors. This is the new one here, and you can't replace just the module, or you can't buy just the module. So we're replacing the whole thing. That's gonna be nice and easy. My door here is giving me a little bit of shade. And no, I don't mean it's throwing shade. Well, last night I was able to get just a little bit of sleep. Which helps. That's not going to be the right size. Nope. That bolt already looks like it's bent a little bit, so I gotta be careful with it. I went from carrying a 6-inch to an 8-inch crescent just for the caps that are on the over the service valves. The 6-inch crescent just couldn't fit on those caps. Go ahead and move that out the way. Don't want to confuse it with the new one. All right, we want my wires to come out right here in between my legs right there. There we go. Move it up a little bit. Come on. Not tight enough yet. There we go. All right, can y'all see that little notch inside the shaft, inside the hub right there? And it's got these three little divots on the outside to show you where to line it up. So that's what we're going to try to do. There we go. Now, is that the way I want it? I know those wires are zip tied, like right here. Mm. you know, that's always going to be close to lined up because of the way they have this groove in the hub. Well, guys, the day started with me doing a compressor, but when I began recovering the refrigerant, I realized there wasn't much in it. So I actually pushed some back into it and did a leak search, and I found a couple leaks, including in the evaporator coil. And this was on a 17-year-old system. So I stopped right there. I advised the homeowner and gave him a quote on a new system. And that's as far as it has gone so far. So we'll see where it goes. That's the one that I found. I used the Megaron the other day at the end of last week. So I'll let y'all know how it goes. I appreciate y'all watching, and I'll catch you on the next one.